Jameson is friendly. He is very welcoming. He has a big heart. He is such a silly, fun-loving little boy. And everyone falls in love with him. We know he's going to go on to do big things. He has a magnetic personality. He draws people in. When Jameson was about 7 months old, we had him fitted for passive prosthesis.
These are prototype arms. They're one of a kind, and they were made especially for Jameson.
The arms also help with hand-eye coordination, vision depth and distance, all things the family had feared their son would never be able to understand.
He's now 18 months, and we've been working with those ever since until this week. And we now have our first set of Myos, and today was the first day we got to see him open and close a hand on his own, which was amazing.
So those passives really set us up for success, you know, yeah. Starting him off as early as we did, you know, kind of questioned it, but at the same time, you know, we asked Mac in our very first, you know, appointment, what would you do if Jameson is your son? What would you do if your son was born a bilateral? And he said, oh, I'd start prosthetics immediately.
It's incredibly important for any child who is going to eventually want to use a prosthesis to start the process as early as possible. As kids become older and are more independent, it's harder at that point to slow them down to then learn how to use a prosthesis.
It's going to be so much easier for him to pick up the prosthesis now as opposed to down the road when he's fully adapted to just his short arms. And we know he's going to do really well with his short arms. And we know he's going to do really well with prosthesis, so he has the best of both worlds.
Do you want the balloon in your hand? Let's put the balloon in your hand. Open up. Put the balloon in. Good job. So the mommy switch part of it will be opening. So if he gets stuck on something, you can push the switch and it'll open up.
One of the reasons we chose AED was because of the response we got in our initial meeting was just that, well, yeah, he can do anything. He can do anything at all. We make prostheses for not only just for, you know, daily activities, but, you know, for whatever it may be, for playing baseball, for swimming, and you know, whatever it is. I mean, it's available, and don't settle for second best, let alone nothing at all.
To allow him to use it for a longer period of time, we've put in a tightening or a lacing system that allows it to open way up so that as he gets bigger, this can fit looser and looser and looser, but still provide the same type of tightness and security.
How is that compared to the old liner?
Yeah,
we really had to make the decision for him to go ahead with this, but we felt that it was the best decision for him.
From the creative end of things, we're able to draw up everything from scratch and just start with just an idea.
Custom built just for Jameson. You can't just get these anywhere. Just here. He may go through phases where he'll go periods of time when he's older and decide that it's not cool or it's cool. It's just going to be up to him, but for now we're making this decision to make it easier for him to decide in the future.
Open.
Excellent job. You did it. Good work.
I always come back to the same thought. It's pretty simple. It's just, you just want to provide the most you can for your kids. You want to give them the best opportunities in life that you can. You know, in Jameson's circumstance, he's a bilateral transradial congenital amputee. So we're out in the world and we're trying to give our son the best tools we can so he can live his life to the fullest.
The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round.